Room service. Hi, just dropping by again, Mrs. Nugent. Pay my respects. Brought you some soaps and a little bubble bath to soothe you in the tub, and some chocolate cupcakes for a late night snack.
Come in.
Oh, that would be my pleasure.
Richard Linklater's true crime caper offers a kind of comic riff on In Cold Blood, framing the murder of a small-town matriarch as a mock documentary. Jack Black plays Bernie, the cuddly mortician, who becomes boon companion to Shirley MacLaine's sour old widow. In the meantime, Matthew McConaughey rears up among the talking heads to make sense of a murder most foul.
One time I got four teenagers to rededicate their lives to Jesus, but eventually I realized I was meant for other equally important things.
Catherine, would you like to have Bernie as your best friend?
Well, everybody in the film says how nice he is endlessly. Actually, he doesn't seem that nice.
No, there's
creepy.
Something fundamentally creepy about
him. Apart from the killing thing, he's also a bit odd. I mean, this is a great film, isn't it? It's a great little unexpected film that was released in America 2 years ago and suddenly come up here. I'm not sure why it's not a documentary, because you have this thing of mixing the talking heads great, fantastically good, and the great people are the real townspeople who chat away.
How many of them are the real townspeople?
The majority.
Right, not Matthew McConaughey, unless he's moved from Beverly Hills.
But you see, and that's slightly jarred for me, because you do, I suppose it's a sort of intentional thing. And
suddenly you just think, there's Matthew McConaughey acting. And he is from Texas, but he just looks like an actor when he's set down among the real people.
And the stockbroker guy, it makes actors look a bit crap, which is an interesting route to go there. But it is terrifically good. I did wish it was a documentary on some levels. I suppose there's lots of reasons why it wasn't, and it does wrong-foot you in an interesting way. But there's too much indulgence of Jack Black. There's too much Jack Black singing. But
maybe
it is
too
really
much
good.
Jack Black off the leash. But Shirley MacLaine, who is known for really kind of chewing the scenery in many of her roles, very, very good in this.
Very good. She's very subtle. And, I thought it was going to give it all the old Downton.
Or Terms of Endearment.
But she didn't.
Yeah, but Linklater's very much on Bernie's side, isn't he? Like, he's signed a petition trying to get the real Bernie out of prison, which the real Bernie is kind of charmingly described as like church camp, which, you know, like, even in prison he's still doing this charm offensive, I guess. And, like, Shirley MacLaine really is the evil old woman with not a lot to do. But at the same time, you do think there's a hidden story there that I think Linklater on purpose just isn't showing us and doesn't want to show us, because you're supposed to go along with Bernie all the way and almost follow this groupthink about him.
He is interested in Bernie, but I almost thought what he was most interested in is small-town Texas life and that particular part of East Texas that is more southern than what we think of as Texas, and that it's very genteel, it's very formal, and there's the questions about, is he gay? And they're kind of not really wanting to sort of touch on that, because that's how they handle those kind of things in that sort of town. And all of that gave it a kind of nice texture that made me think that we don't really see a film about that world that's not the fish out of water comedy.
That's true, absolutely, and I think that's why I wished it was a documentary, because I wanted more of the authentic.
It could almost be an Errol Morris kind of film.
but that's what was fabulous, wasn't it? Was those little sound bites of the real people.
I think also Jack Black's performance in this is the reason why it's a good drama rather than a great documentary, in that Jack Black is someone who's weirdly likeable and completely unlikable at the same time for a lot of people, myself included. And I think he's perfect for this role, because he can just about go to that level where you're like, God, you're really irritating. But that works perfectly for someone like Bernie, who's supposed to be that.
And weirdly, McConaughey is that as well, in a very different way.
Yeah.
So Linklater's good on using those kind of double-edged people.
Almost
and McClane, too.
But not quite,
But I think for me that was the problem with it, is that Jack Black is just not... I mean, like, everybody's... All the town's ladies say, you were just desperate for a date with Bernie. It's like, actually, just really wouldn't. Whereas you see pictures of the real-life Bernie, he's quite a hunk, you know, or he was. You know, you would.
Before prison got to him.
Church camp.
There are people in town, honey, that would have shot her for $5.
Everybody's describing Bernie Tiede as an angel.
The nicest fella I've ever met.
He didn't do it.
He's an angel, all right. An angel of death.
That dog don't hunt.